million orphan children living in Afghanistan, according to UNICEF. One American moved there to help, and now he's showing Afghan orphans what life is like here in the United States. Asiye Namdar has the story. So we're standing outside CNN World Headquarters, and we're waiting for a group of very special Afghan children. These kids have seen poverty, hardship, conflict, and they've been basically growing up in an orphanage that's run by this woman that I did this story on last year on CNN.com, and her name is Andy Shefarid. Six of the kids, two teachers, one RV. This is Hala, one of the girls. I think I know everybody's name. You would be so proud. Okay, Shakufa, yeah. Maria, Araj, Mohsen, Lida, Nasreen. And what's my name?
Asia.
Perfect. And that's Ian Pounds, their incredible teacher, who's here with the group as their guide, as their teacher. And that's Nasreen, another one of the amazing teachers.
The two girls are sleeping. Shagufa and Maria are sleeping there.
Okay.
Lida and Hala, they are sleeping there.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
And the two boys.
And Ian.
Sleeping. Yeah.
Very nice. And so when you guys travel from city to city,
yeah,
where does he park the RV?
Mostly the families, they have a parking place by their
okay,
house.
Okay, so you never have to spend the night time in here.
We spend the night here.
Okay.
But we go for lunch or like for dinner at their houses.
Got it.
For sleeping.
Thank you, Nasreen. Ian Pounds, who really gave up his life in America to go to Kabul and dedicated to educating these wonderful kids. So, Ian, tell me a little bit about this project and what it's all about.
Well, when I was 7 years old, my parents brought us across country in a station wagon. I'm doing the same thing with my kids from Kabul. What better way to really immerse yourself in a culture, in the environment, in the world of America, than load up on an RV and go all the way across and back? So it's about immersion, enrichment, language skills, communication skills, worldliness, and poise in front of people, everything that this kind of adventure can do to bring more skills into the kids' lives. It's also a chance to connect with sponsors of children from AFSCCO, who help support AFSCCO and keep the orphanages going.
And tell us what AFSCCO stands for.
Afghan Child Education and Care Organization. It's run by Andisha Farid, an Afghan woman who herself was raised in war.
We're here at the CNN studios with Kira Phillips. The kids, Ian and Nasreen, are getting ready to go on the air and talk about their adventure.
Here we are, and we are only a quarter of the way through of the journey.
And Maria, what has stood out to you being here in the United States?
It's amazing. I like very much here. I learned more things and many experience.
Is there a place, a food?
I like the lobster in Philadelphia. When I went there, I like very much the tall buildings, lots of light. No.
And you also visited the Liberty Bell,
yes,
right?
Yeah.
What a wonderful road trip. Well, Asiye Namdar wrote two great articles about the organization working to help orphans in Afghanistan. You'll find those links at CNN.com/backstory. Bitter cold temperature.